Boy, howdy. That was a nice challenge, wasn't it? And now, I'll ride proper cool down. This time, I remembered a towel. So that way, I won't slip and fall in a puddle of my own sweat again. Because as funny as that was, it hurt. It's still a little slick, so I'm gonna hold on to this. Watch out, puppy. And just swing it up. Move over here to this side. To this side. Just kick him straight up. Alright. Go back to left, just kick him back. I'm so wondering from that full body countdown challenge. Now just up to the side. Other side. Grab a net, just walk out. Lay your hands out. Step outside and sit down. All right, other side. Set that down. Take a deep breath in. Now we're going to go ahead and stand on our hands, right? Okay. And then just relax your upper body and just extend your legs. that feels really good. Because for me, you know, I got three vertebrae in my thoracic region right between my shoulder blades. Got a little compacted and twisted, right? And so what that does for me is it helps to elongate my spine and decompress that section right there, helping it to properly align a little bit better and relieve a lot of the sharp pain between my shoulder blades that happens, you know. But injuries happen and you gotta learn to live with them and adapt and try to find a way to make your life better in spite of them. So that's what I'm about. That's what I do. I work out to feel good. Reach and stretch.
Oh yeah.
Watch out, puppy. Grabbing this knee, bring it into your chest. Just lay back. Grab that foot and get that thing out. Take it over in this end and kick it up the other way. Oh yeah. And if you grab that outside of your foot, you get a nice blade going on it. Oh man, it's causing a quiver. Woo, it's good. And relax. Wow. You'll see what I'm talking about with this one. So first, let's do this game. Grab this. Throw the ball and lean back. Grab his toes right here and kick it up. And then grab it. See how I grab the outside here and kick it out. You get a nice blade going. Get a nice stretch right her here. Oh yeah. Alright. Shake that out. That feels good right there. Alright, now we're gonna roll over. Now we get to keep our hips on the ground and get to press our upper body. Then press your hips back.
You don't have to sit through 12 commercials and a 3-alarm dumpster fire for morning show just to get to it.
Hallelujah!
Tulsa's real rock is on 105.7
to 5. Back to the tabletop. Now we're just going to kick our feet out wide and just bring your hips down. Come bend your knees and come back. Back and then nice and slow. And then go nice and slow. Now press that back and get a nice little release through that ankle. Get the other side. And now we're going to come back. We go all the way down the stair. pain, come on, nice and slow. Get out of my sweat towel. Speaking of which. Woo! I'm out here making like sweat angels and stuff, you know? Stop licking me. Go lay down. Oh, these puppies are silly. Let's go ahead and get a little rotation through our torso and stretch through the outer glute, right? So here we go. The medial. You know what I'm saying? The medial.
So your medial glutes. Mm-hmm. Feels real good, dude. Yes, a stretch.
That feels good. One more reach. Get as far as you can. Breathe out and relax. Go ahead and take your arms down to your sides. Just go ahead and fall palms up. Oh yeah. Take this last minute. Just to lay here. With the puppy.
105.7 the bottom. More new rock. More often.
My sweat quenches his thirst. He's like, oh my god, you're so salty. Yeah. Alright. Oh. And that's it for today. Thanks again for joining me with this right proper cool down after today's full body countdown challenge. Woo, it's a nice challenge for me. Man, I got a nice pec pump going on. I'm looking like I got something going on here, you know? Hoo-yah! Anyways, thanks again for joining me. And until next time, be excellent to yourself and each other.